Before we start programming, we need to set up our development environment. We are going to start out by using an IDE, or Integrated Development Environment, to write our C++ code, even though using an IDE isn't required to write a C++ program. You could write a program with a normal text editor, think Notepad, but don't use Notepad. And then you could build the program with a compiler, which is a program that builds it into an executable file. In this window, I've used a command line-based text editor called Nano to write a simple C++ program. A compiler is just a program that turns your source code into an executable file, so we could just call it from the command line. I'm just pointing it out so that you know it's possible, but we're not going to do that in class. An IDE is an integrated development environment. Generally, it is a fancy text editor with syntax highlighting, debugging tools, and it usually has the build and compile options available from within the program, so you don't have to compile externally. Note that the IDE is not the compiler. The compiler is a separate piece, and many IDEs let you use whatever compiler you want. Generally, it should not matter which compiler you use for writing C++ programs, since C++ is a standardized language, but you might run into different things being supported with different compilers. It shouldn't be a problem for us since we're not doing anything too out of the ordinary. So, what do you need to download? The school has Visual Studio available on its computers, but what if you want to work on your own machine? One option is to download Visual Studio Community Version. It is a free version of Visual Studio and it's meant for, quote, individual developers, open source projects, academic research, education, and small professional teams. So basically, if you're going to run a gigantic corporation, you're not really allowed to use Visual Studio Community, I would assume. You should probably license it. Just do a search for Visual Studio Community Download to find the download link. I prefer CodeBlocks. It's cross-platform, whereas Visual Studio is currently just for Windows, and it's also lighter weight, so if you have a slower computer, this will probably run a lot better than Visual Studio will. If you're not using Windows at home, this is my favorite option. Also note that CodeBlocks is free to use for any reason. And if you're using it on Windows, you should download the version with the MinGW compiler. You'll see MinGW in the name of the setup file. Another IDE is Xcode. Xcode is by Apple, and it's their IDE for using their special languages like Objective-C and Swift, but it also supports languages like C++. So did you get one downloaded? Let's step through creating a new project, adding files to the project, building and compiling, and some really simple debugging. When you first open Visual Studio, go to the File menu, select New, and click on Project. Under the Visual C++ category, choose Empty Project. At the bottom of this dialog, you can set the project name and the path on your hard drive. Visual Studio will then create a project with no files in it for you. Right-click on the project in the Solution Explorer, select Add, and choose New Item. In the Visual C++ category, choose a C++ file. At the bottom, give the file a name. I usually name it main.cpp. Now we have an empty place to write our code. I'm just going to write a really simple program to test with. I'm clicking on the gray bar to the left of the line numbers, which sets a breakpoint. Your project might close automatically when you run it if you don't do this. You can build the project by going to the Build menu and selecting Build Solution. There's an output dialog at the bottom that will tell you the build status and will let you know if you have any compile errors. You can run the program by clicking on the Play button. This will also ask if you want to build the project if you've made any changes without building. If you have made any changes, you will need to build again. So our simple program runs. Let's do some debugging. I'm going to add some variables to our program. Then we will debug to check the values of those variables. We will go over this code in more depth in another lecture. I'm setting a breakpoint at the beginning of the program so we can step through the whole thing. Now our program is running, but Visual Studio has paused it before it has output Hello World. Click the Debug menu. Under the Windows menu, select Locals. This menu shows us the variables that will be used here. Right now, A, B, and C are filled with garbage because we have not assigned any values to them at this point in the program. We can use the Step Over button to step through each line of the code. Hello World shows up after we step past the Cout line. Once we step past a variable declaration, the Locals window shows the new value of that variable. This can be useful when debugging a tricky problem, so you know what is going on at each line of the program. The various stepping options are also available through the Debug drop-down menu. When you want to reopen your work, find it on the hard drive and open the solution or the SLN file. Okay, now let's go over the same steps in code blocks. It's up to you which IDE you want to use. When you start code blocks, go to the File menu, select New, and then Project. In this window, select Empty Project and hit Go. Here you set the project title, and you choose the path where it's going to be stored on your hard drive. Then click Next. Just keep both Debug and Release checked by default and hit Finish. Now we have an empty project with no files in it. Go to File, New, and Empty File. It will ask if you want to save the file, so click Yes. Name it whatever you like, but I go with main. Put .cpp at the end of your file name. Another window will pop up. Just have Debug and Release checked and click OK. Now this file is part of our project. I'm going to write some sample code really quick, and then we'll build and run the project. You can click on this gear icon to build the project, or go to the Build menu to build. There's a build log at the bottom of the screen that will display compile progress, and it will also let you know if there are any build errors. You can click Run or Build and Run from the Build menu to run the program. You will need to build every time you make changes. I'm going to add some variables to our program, then we will debug to check the value of those variables. Again, we'll go over this code more in depth in a different lecture. I'm going to set a breakpoint by clicking to the right of the line number. Then instead of build and run, select start/continue from the debug menu. The program is now paused before it has printed Hello World. Go to the debug menu, select debugging windows, and open the watches window. This window tells us what variables will be used here. Currently, everything's set to garbage because we haven't initialized them yet, since we're at the very beginning of the program. You can use the next line command to go to the next line in the program and watch the watches window as it updates the variable values. When you want to open your project again, find the project folder on your hard drive and open the CBP file. We'll be doing a lot of coding, so you'll get better with these tools the more you use them. If you have any questions, let me know.